How are you all? I hope you all are doing well. You all are fine. You all are good. Okay. Students, in this class we will learn something about rayon. But before that, we will find out how strong is nylon. Activity number 4, as I promised, I'll do in our last. Like I would love to explain you in the last class. Again, I'll repeat that one. And here we will read today about rayon as well, which is another type of synthetic. Plastic or synthetic fiber, which you can say. And before that, I hope you are finished. You people are finishing your homeworks. You are staying at your house. You are reading properly all the subjects, following each and every rules which has been given to you or which has been noted to you by school. Friends, please follow everything. When you will come to school, we will check your all homeworks and all. Okay. Let's get started. Activity number 4, which is how strong is nylon. Let us write. Parachute cloths, rock climbing ropes. These are very tough things which are made with the help of nylon. Why these things are made with nylon? Is nylon that too strong? Let us find out in this particular experiment. Take an iron stand with a clamp, take cotton, wool, nylon and silk threads about 50 cm in length. Tie a knot thread to the stand so that it hangs freely from at free end. Attach a pan so that a weight can be placed on it. Add weight starting from 10 gram one by one till the thread breaks down. Note down the total weight required to break the thread and repeat the same activity with wool, silk and nylon and fill the table. First we will take 50 cm length of wool, cotton, silk. We will take nylon. Okay, have all of them are 50 centimeter. Then we will take one iron stand. Okay, a long iron stand we will take. It has a clamp on it. Okay, now we will tie the rope like string over here. We will put a knot over there. Okay, so that we can hang a plate and we can put weights over there and we will see which string can weigh too much, okay, which can support large amount of weight. The rope which will hold large amount of weight or enough amount of weight, we will call it as perfect one. We will call it the strongest one. That will be the winner. So let's do the same activity one by one. Okay, students. This we have to take. I will tie one string over there. Okay. You place one plate. Now this plate has to be like it has to be like the same way. Okay. We will take different kind of ropes. First we will take wool. We will see. We will place 10 grams. Then another 10 gram. Another 10 gram. We will say 30 gram. It breaks. Now we will take cotton. Again it is opposite. It took 35 and it breaks. We will take silk. It took around suppose 25 and it breaks. When we talk about nylon, you will see it will take about 100 grams. About 100 grams it will take. It will not gonna break. So from this experiment, what we will get? From this experiment, we can get that the nylon is the strongest one in this all the four ropes which we have taken. So in this way, we can end our nylon part. It is very strong, students. Okay. Next is about rayon. There are lot of facts about rayon, students. We have a number of facts about rayon which I need to say to you. First one is rayon. Rayon is called as artificial silk. It is called as artificial silk. Rayon is called as what, students? Artificial silk. Means it is the perfect replica of silk. So how it is made? Students, it is made from plants only, but it is following some unnatural, like some chemical processes. After that we are getting it. Okay, how? Let us see, let us find out. We know about natural silk, which is obtained from silkworm. Fabrics made of silk are very costly. It is not even accessible to all. Production maintenance of silk clothes are very different, also very difficult, and it takes time to process as well as to make. But its texture fascinates everyone. But its quality, its texture fascinates everyone. Like everybody want to hold a silk cloth. Okay. For many years, scientists attempted to make silk artificially, and their efforts were successful towards the end of the 19th century. As you all know, silk we have found out in around 2nd century or 3rd century, I don't know what exactly was the date, at China. Okay, and they have kept their silk trade and all very ideal to them only, and they used to make routes and they used to distribute the silk along the world, silk route, which we can say. And after that, all scientists were behind the silk only. They were trying to develop a natural, like artificial kind of silk, which can be perfect replica for your silk which was present. Okay, they tried a lot, but they couldn't find out. Later on, the end of 19th century, they found it out. End of 19th century means around 1819, like that time. Okay, they found it out. What was that? How they found out? The first commercial production of artificial silk was achieved in USA in 1911. The first commercial production means easily available to everybody was found out in USA in 1911. Okay. Then this fiber was named as rayon only in 1924. After finding 13 years. Okay, first it was found out in 1911 in USA. In 1924, it got its name as rayon. After 13 years of production, it got its name as rayon. This first factory rayon in India was established in Kerala in 1946. Remember, students, 1946, first rayon factory in India. Rayon factory in India, that is your Kerala. In Kerala, we got our first rayon production unit, that is in 1946. Okay, next. Now, how this rayon is prepared? Now, let us go for the mystery, how this silk replica was made. We noted that petrochemicals are the source material for many polymers and synthetic fibers. Yes, for all kind of synthetic fibers, we can see petrochemicals are the very base products, but The source material for rayon is wood pulp. Wood pulp means whenever you are seeing a wood, piece of wood, you can see the outer layer, that will be called as wood pulp. Okay, for this we need wood pulp. It is the only synthetic fiber obtained from plant. Remember, this is the only synthetic fiber obtained from plant. You can say that only synthetic fiber obtained from plants. Okay, yes, you got it. This line is very important, students. It will come in your exam. And what we are using fiber obtained from plant is cellulose, and so it is called cellulose fiber. So which component used? I write it. The component used in making rayon is wood pulp, and it contains what? It contains cellulose. It contains what, students? Cellulose. So we will call it as cellulose fiber. Its other name is called as cellulose fiber. A question may come, why rayon is called as cellulose fiber? The answer is, rayon is prepared from wood pulp, and wood pulp contains a large amount of cellulose, and it is prepared from cellulose, so it is called as cellulose fiber. Are you all cleared, students? Yes, you all are cleared. Okay. The cellulose was collected from wood and bamboo pulp. It is treated with several chemicals. First, sodium hydroxide is added, then carbon disulfide is added to cellulose. The cellulose dissolves in the chemicals and added it to give a syrup which is called viscose. The viscose is forced through a spirit, okay, into a solution of dilute sulfuric acid. This gives us silk like threads, and the threads are cleaned with soap and dried with new fiber called rayon. Okay, it is very complex process. Let me find out. Let me write it down in a simple language for you all. How we will make it? Here, what all chemicals are used, students? I'll write one by one. First, it is used sodium hydroxide. First, sodium hydroxide is used. Second, carbon disulfide. Yes? Yes, second is your carbon disulfide is used. Symbols are not given, but we will keep their symbol NaOH. This one as CS2. Carbon disulfide. These two are used at first. How they will do? They will take a container. In that container, they will take what? Wood pulp. They will take what, students? Wood pulp. And they will add NaOH. They will add what? That one, sodium hydroxide, they will add. Plus, they will add what? CH2, carbon disulfide. Now, this will form the combination of three. Is called as viscose. The combination of three is called what, students? Viscose. Combination of these three will be called as viscose. You need to remember this one. Now what will happen? The viscose will give us. Now this viscose means a thick liquid. This liquid is forced to pass through. Suppose I will make a pipeline over there. Now these are forced to pass through. A chamber where they contain very small holes, small hole type chamber will be there, and this kind of chamber will be called as spinet. We have read already, no? In our last class, spinneret, right? Why I am writing this? This spelling you need to remember. If you change it, it will change the meaning, okay? It is supposed to pass through spinet. Now from these spinets, we will get rays. What? Threads. Is it the end of the process? No, this is not the end of the process. Now they will be what? Where they will come out? They will come to another chamber. That chamber is full of what? Hydrogen? Sorry, sulfuric acid. That is full of dilute sulfuric acid. What it will contain, students? Dilute sulfuric acid. It contains more dilute sulfuric acid. Now they will be rinsed in dilute sulfuric acid. Then we will get threads. Now the threads are coming to another board, very big washing tub, very huge washing tub, where they will be washed with the help of soap. What? Soap. What? Now we are ready with our rayon threads. Now what will happen? Rayon is a natural fiber, artificial kind of. Some kind of rayons are made from the short cotton fibers left on the cotton seed after ginning. After ginning, ginning is the process. What is ginning? Is your you need to comment in our comment section. What is ginning? What is the process called ginning? You need to say in the comment section. You people need to, because you have read in your 7th class. Okay, after ginning, students, some of the cotton threads are remained. With that cotton threads also, we can prepare rayon. Rayon is cheaper than silk and can be woven like silk fiber. It gives us a texture and texture like your silk, but it is very much cheaper as compared to that. And it can be dyed in wide variety of colors. You can dye with any variety of color as you want. What are the uses of rayon? And is it only used for your clothes, or any different kind of works are there? Yes, it has several different kinds of work. Rayon is mixed with cotton to make seeds. Rayon is mixed with wool to make huge carpets. Rayon is often used in fashion and home furnishing materials. Rayon is also found in sanitary products, diapers and bandages, lints for dressing wounds. Everything are made up of rayon. Rayon is not a perfect fiber to prepare all fabrics, because it is made up from plant cellulose. It absorbs water easily, and absorbing water makes the rayon weak and causes fiber to break easily. Every fiber is having its own disadvantage, students. Rayon was very cheap, it is easy to use and all, but one problem is it is very weak. Why? It is made up of cellulose, so it can absorb a lot of amount of water. Absorbing a lot of amount of water, resulting in a problem. That result, what kind of problem may be resulting? The problem is they may break, because absorbing lot of amount of water, it will dissolve the rayon and it will be weak, and it can easily be broken down. We cannot make strong wires and all stuff with the help of rayon. So this is the end of our rayon lesson. In our next class we will learn. See, in this class I said it is mixed with wool to make seeds, it's mixed with somebody to make seeds. The way I said, in our next class we will learn why do we combine fibers, and by combining fiber what kind of things we can get. So students, thank you for listening. In the next class we will see how do we combine fibers. Bye bye.